I'm going to make an attempt to create the most basic MidJourney guide tutorial that'll help any newbies or beginners understand how MidJourney works. It's basically a step-by-step guide behind the scenes that'll help you get started right away. I'll try to keep it very simple and straight to the point. I've used MidJourney for quite some time. I was on their free trial, which has limitations, 25 images. And I was also on their paid plan for quite some time. But then I didn't stick for long because I was playing with a lot of AI tools I was exploring, which I'll discuss down the road, until MidJourney version 5 comes out, which has insane potential. So I decided to sign up for the pro version, which the plan features 30-hour fast generations, unlimited relaxed generations, general commercial terms, access to member gallery, optional credit top-ups, stealth image generation, 12 concurrent fast jobs. This is important. This is one of the features that impresses me and what I need to use this, the pro version. You get 30 hours in rollover and bonus, so it renews every month. Now let's get straight to the point. This is going to help you get started, all right? You have to join their Discord, which is the first thing you should do. There are a lot of things which I will skip over. However, I encourage you to go through all of them. It has prompts. Feel free to check it out. And like I said, I'm going to keep it straight to the point and basic. Imagine, and that's a standard prompt we'll be using as an example. All right. So I will show you all of these in action. All right. Direct messages, emojis, invite the bot to your server. Invite the MidJourney bot to any Discord server to create with friends or make a personal Discord server to organize work. Once the MidJourney bot has joined the server, you can begin interacting with it using the imagine command. Images generated on private servers are still visible to other users on MidJourney.com. To use the MidJourney bot in any server, users must have an active MidJourney trial or subscription. Using imagine for the first time will automatically begin a trial membership for new users. So if you interact with the bot, the first interaction will get you in the trial mode. And then you can invite the MidJourney bot to your own server, okay? And that's all you need to know. You have this remix, you have multi-prompts, etc., which we'll go through in a second, okay? You have upscalers, some of the commands here, and that's it. You have two choices. You can use Discord web version or the desktop version. This is the web version, okay? This is the server I've created, and you can literally create a server, whatever server you want, all right? So I've just created a server. I call it Elite System AI. And you can create multiple channels here, okay? I created a channel called MidJourney. You can create multiple just to keep them organized. If you want to keep just one for backgrounds, where you want to just create backgrounds, and you can just have one separate for that. You can have a separate one for just avatars. You can, if you have a business or a niche, you can just have that. If you have a cat niche, you can have a cat channel, where you can just create all the images for cats. So you can separate them, right? Now, if you notice, I've invited the MidJourney bot right over here, right? So in order to do so, you could just go to MidJourney and click on Add to Server, and you can select whichever lit system, that's the server, continue, and you have to give its permission, authorize, and that's it. So since it's already there, it didn't do anything, all right? However, if it wasn't there, you can clearly see I've signed up earlier on. So it'll send you a DM. You could literally type the command here, imagine. However, I wouldn't do it here. I've chose to create a private server because I want to keep everything organized. So I will be doing it right over here, okay? So currently, this channel was set to private channel. That's why. Now you can see the bot. Now, if we say imagine prompt, right? You can put whatever keyword here and it's going to give me that. Cat in a space suit. So give it a few seconds, and since I'm a paid user, I'm on the fast mode, and this is what it gave me. If you go back on their tutorial guide, they explain very clearly that they'll give you 4 images. You can choose whichever version, right? And I'm going to show you exactly that. And on top of that, this is something you can play with, which I will explain in the next episode. Blending. This is where you can blend with your own image prompts. You can upload your own images and it'll basically blend and do its magic. Okay, so image prompts, it actually needs its own dedicated section. Basically, example, starting images, statue, right? Just look at this and it'll give you a sense of what exactly it does. So flowers, statue, sea, coral, ocean, and you see how it integrates everything together, right? And gives you various stuff. Image prompts in V3. We are in V5. So expect it to be on the next level right now. All right, so we have this. If you don't like it, this is V1, V2, V3, V4, variations. If you want a variation of version 1, you can click on this, upscale. If you want this upscaled, you can click on this, all right? It'll tell you what it does. So if I want this upscaled, I can click on this. However, let's say I like this image, the fourth one, and I want a variation of this one. I'm gonna click on V4. So making variations for image number 4 with prompt cat in spacesuit. If you like this image, right now it gave me variations of this image, right? And that's what's happening, okay? If you like this image, you click on this image, open in browser, and now you can save this entire image. However, if you want to select individual images, you have to click on, let's say you want this one, click on upscale 1. All right, so now it gave me an upscaled version of this image. If you want to download this, just click on this, open in browser, save image, and that's it. Now you can use whenever you want, wherever you want, right? This one, I could have easily moved over to the cat section. That's exactly what I said. You can create different text channels and keep them separate. All right, so this is the most basic example. And the best part, if you watched the previous video where I talked about the Chrome extension, it also has a lot of MidJourney prompt generators. Let's say I pick one of these, MidJourney prompt ultra detailed. Let's pick on this, write a description, robots. It's giving me the prompt, which I have to copy and paste it on Discord, on MidJourney, right? So look at this, I'm gonna copy this. I'll go to MidJourney over here. Or if I wanna just use this, paste it. And let's see what it says, what it does. Okay, that's interesting. Kind of weird. I wasn't expecting this exactly. That's why I said, play with the prompts. This is the best part of, oh, hold on, this is getting better now. Wow. That's why they said, do not judge too early. That's pretty cool, detailed. Open in browser, play with different prompts. Once you find something that works, you can stick with it, try different variations. We have variations 1, 2, 3, 4, upscale, and that's about it. You can use a tone here, optimistic, authoritative, writing style, play with different prompts. And last but not the least, I remember I talked about the stealth mode. In order to activate stealth mode, we will have to type the stealth command. And that's about it. Stealth generation enabled. And what is this? And why it's a big deal? Well, it's not exactly a big deal, but the point is, if you get on MidJourney, right? When you start on MidJourney, this is a trial support. This is how you start, basically. Okay, you're in the member support, you're the trial support, you type, imagine, they'll give you whatever images, and it gets overwhelming. If you look at one of these, the windows, people are generating, and it's public, okay? Everything is public. It's just too much, it's overwhelming. That's why the best thing is to create your own server. And when you become the paid, member, then you can bring the MidJourney bot to your server and do all this stuff. However, if you don't enable stealth, it'll still be visible to public. Just because it's on your server doesn't mean public can't see it, okay? Stealth is basically, well, if you go on their page, let me actually show you. Subscribers to the Pro Plan have access to stealth mode to prevent their images from being visible to others on the MidJourney website. The stealth and public commands toggle between stealth and public mode. Stealth mode only prevents others from viewing your images on midjourney.com, okay? Images generated in public channels are always visible to other users, even while using stealth mode. Remember this, images generated in public channels are always visible. To prevent others from seeing an image you create using stealth mode, generate images in your direct messages or in a private Discord server. See, to prevent others from seeing an image you create using stealth mode, generate images in your direct messages. So this over here, what I just did, now this is complete stealth mode. It's on my server and I'm using stealth mode. So whatever I do from now, people won't be able to see it. You can do work on this peacefully, and that's about it. So if you found this useful, like I said, I will try to keep it simple, but I guess I went all over the place. But just wanted to show you, this is exactly how it works, okay? Step one, join their Discord, and then they have this simple guide here. And the only thing you need to know is the imagine and whatever keywords and stuff. And to start getting, just to get started with prompting, check on this GPT, the extension I mentioned in the previous video, play with it, and that's about it. I'll have a much detailed version down the road. If you like it, subscribe, and thank you for watching.